Have you ever wondered how the engineers managed to construct large structures like bridges or dams whose substructures are submerged underwater? Because most of our construction equipments and materials are not suitable to work underwater. Or we have to use some specific equipments specially designed for underwater construction which might not be financially feasible. This also applies to labor and workers. Most of the time, if the underwater construction is long-term, coffer dam is one of the best solutions many engineers make use of, where they get rid of the water from the surrounding area so as to provide a safe and dry surrounding to work. So let's see what these coffer dams are. Typically, they are just a kind of small dam made up of locally available material like soil and stones. The height of the coffer dam is kept at least 1 meter above the maximum water level, and then water is pumped out completely. Sometimes the removal of water may cause the negative pressure, and if the soil underneath the earthen coffer dam is porous, it allows the seepage of water. To prevent this, sheet piles are driven from center of the dam. Height of this dam can be up to 3 meter. Sometimes if rocks are found easily at local level, rock-filled coffer dams are also used. If required depth is more, up to 6 meter, then long steel sheets are used and are pushed inside the soil below until it reaches the hard strata. Thus, it prevents the water seepage and it is also useful when there is less area available for coffer dam construction, like in case of bridge piers or when there is an existing structure in nearby area. Generally, the construction process follows these steps. First, a braced frame is erected on the support piles. Then set of steel sheet piles are inserted and pushed deep down the soil until they reach hard strata. The pile driving process generally starts from corners, meeting at center. Water is then removed with the help of series of pumps. After removal of water, sometimes excavation is done inside the coffer dam to remove loose material. Now, if there is no rock or firm soil beneath, then piles are driven until hard rock is met and a concrete seal may then be placed on these piles to cut off the seepage water from the soil below. Now, finally, the new structure is constructed. After the structure has gained strength, the coffer dam is flooded. Then the sheet piles and bracings are removed and the space around structure is backfilled with soil. The concrete seal placed to cut off the water seepage may be used as part of the substructure. When water level is more than 20 meter, cellular coffer dams are used. These coffer dams are made by driving steel sheet piles so that they form interconnected cells. Then these cells are filled with clay, broken bricks or sand so that it remains stable against various forces acting. The construction of these cells can be done individually in any order. On the other hand, when one cell is completely filled, it can be used as a platform to equipments, and same way other cells are constructed one by one. The major advantage of this coffer dam is that all the cells act as independent self-supporting unit So if one of them cells collapses due to interlock damage or something, it does not affect adversely on neighboring cells and a catastrophe can be prevented. Thus, they can be used even for width more than 21 meter and are generally used for construction of dam, locks, etc. We should keep in mind that cofferdam cannot remove water completely. Water will anyway enter inside a cofferdam through small gaps between steel sheets or seepage. So this water has to be pumped out constantly. After the construction work is complete, cofferdam is removed. Thus, it is a temporary structure and mostly it is made up of locally available material, so not so costly to construct. For dam construction, two cofferdams are usually built, one on the upstream side and another on the downstream side of proposed dam site. This will lead to increase in water level and pressure at upstream side, which may be dangerous to the workers. So water is diverted by tunnels or channels so that flow of water bypass the construction area of dam. After the construction work is over, cofferdam on downstream side is removed and channels are closed. This will lead to rise of water level at upstream side and it will automatically drown the upstream side cofferdam. So this is all about cofferdam. If you like the video, hit like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.